Welcome to this Consepsys Document Control Tip of the Month. In this issue, we discuss the question, how to live with two document numbering structures. In an ideal world, all documents within the same organization should be numbered according to a same and unique document numbering structure. This would allow maximum control and it would minimize administration and confusion. However, in the real world, some organizations have to live with two and sometimes even more document numbering structures, either because they have no choice or sometimes, on the contrary, because it makes a lot more sense. When you think of it, it is not unusual for an organization to operate with several document numbering structures. For example, general and technical documentation on one hand and correspondence on the other hand. Or legacy documents and more recent documents, or internal documents and documents from or for external organizations, or internal documents and project documents from or for external organizations, or two distinct document numbers on the same document, for example, one for the client or employer and the other for the contractor. However, there are risks associated with using two or more numbering structures. It can confuse users, it may be more difficult to find documents, it can create hazardous situations. Therefore, the approach to operate with two or more document numbering structures must be carefully developed and thought through. This approach should include asking questions which include, but which are not limited to the following. Do we need several registers, one for each document numbering structure, or can we have both in the same register? Does our electronic document management software accommodate all documents, regardless of their numbering structure? If we are using a new document numbering structure, do we need to renumber all our legacy documents? This is just a small sample of questions that should be considered. The good news is that there are clean ways to operate with several document numbering structures. However, the philosophy and the rules behind this duality must be clear and consistent. Good practices in operating with two or more document numbering structures include having several columns in the document register, one column showing the legacy number for each document, and another column showing the new document numbering structure. The use of metadata or properties or tags attached to the document in the electronic document management software. If the number of documents allows it, renumbering of legacy documents after a new document numbering structure has been decided. The addition of a watermark on legacy documents, showing the new document number. Agreement on a single common official document numbering structure in situations where several organizations collaborate. If this is not possible, showing the client document number and the contractor document number on the same document as long as they are clearly differentiated. These are just a few examples of good practices for operating with several document numbering structures. Some of these techniques can be combined. If you wish to learn more about document numbering structures, watch these videos and attend our course Certified Document Controller. You will find all the links in the description. How many document numbering structures do you live with at work? Describe them in the comments. Have you ever had to change document numbering structures? Let us know how it went.
We regularly release new content on document control. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel, to like this video, and to hit the notification bell to be notified of any useful new content.